For many years, poker tournaments were the only type of televised poker available. But around 2006, TV shows like High Stakes Poker started making televised cash games more popular. And with these new shows, something called Running It Twice emerged and has been a popular feature of card rooms and home games ever since. But how does running it twice, thrice, or even 44 times affect your odds? We'll take an in-depth look at this poker option today on Jack Ace. What up, donkeys? Jack Hayes here with JackHayes.com, where we talk about my three favorite topics: gambling, crypto, and math. Today, we're going to look at the math behind a poker cash game option called Running It Twice and how it affects your bottom line. Running It Twice is an option when two players go all in and there are still unknown cards to be dealt. Instead of letting one run of the cards seal their fate, they can agree to deal the unknown cards multiple times, with each result giving the winner a fraction of the pot. So if there's just one card left to be dealt, they can run it once, twice, thrice, and theoretically up to 44 times, resulting in 44 equally sized pots. So if you ran it twice, one of three things would happen. You could win both hands, meaning you would win the entire pot. You could lose both hands, meaning you would lose the entire pot. Or you could win one hand and lose the other, and you and your opponent would split the pot. So here's an example where Frank Kassela flopped the nut straight and Maria Ho flopped the middle set.
Call him.
Call in and call.
Doesn't matter to me, what do you want to do?
Twice.
Twice is good.
And Maria made the call. They've agreed to run it twice, as the seven on the turn means she can chop it with an eight, but she can also win the first run out with a pair on the board, which she gets. Full house for Maria. Kassela needs a clean run out here. Just to get half the pot, despite flopping the nuts. The river is another five. Maria fills up twice, and it's going to scoop this $110,000 pot.
So in this example, Maria Ho hit one of her seven outs twice in the two hands, meaning she won both of the half pots.
All right, I guess I'm all in.
I call. Kings.
I got three nines.
You lie, be kidding me.
You want to deal it four times or what?
Four times?
Yeah, it gives you a better chance to win.
Damn sure do. Cool. Run them out, baby.
All right, four times.
Run number one, a jack of hearts.
Queen. Yeah, queen, king.
The river and ace of diamonds. Round one goes to Hellmuth.
So how does running it multiple times affect your expected value, or EV? Most veteran poker players know that running it multiple times has zero effect on your expected value, or EV. Also, they know that running it multiple times will lower your variance around the expected result. And the more times you run it, the lower your variance will be. And today I'm going to prove mathematically that this is true for all number of outs, unknown cards, and number of runouts when drawing to the river.
Run two. The turn, a king.
There we go. Yes. Full house. That's what I'm talking about, you're baby. Get me there.
If you ran it twice, you got money back.
Yeah. Oh, damn, I said four times, though. Damn, didn't I? Holy snap. I got to stand back up now. I thought it was only twice. Come on.
The river's a three.
15% dog. Ernest has won the second pot.
So that's cool. I'm feeling good right now.
The simplest example I can think of is a player drawing to a one-outer on the river. In this case, there are 44 unknown cards, and only one of them will result in him winning the hand. If they only run it once, he has a 1 in 44 chance of winning the entire pot, and if the pot is $44, his EV will be 44 over 44, which is $1. So let's go to the opposite extreme and run it 44 times. Of course, to do this, we have to ignore some formalities like burning cards and just deal out the 44 unknown cards. And once you've dealt all 44 hands, the hero will win one hand and lose 43, and if the pot were $44, that would result in $1 being given back to him. So in these two extreme cases, the EV was identical at 1/44th of the pot, or $1. But in the case of running it 44 times, the variance was zero. It was exactly $1 of EV being returned to the player.
Round three, a seven of spades.
Everybody's rooting for a spade.
He can now hit a king or a spade to win this run.
The river. It is a spade!
God damn!
Spade! Up 2-1! That's loose cannon! He's up 2-1!
Why did you go for four times?
But in the real world, no one's going to agree to running it 44 times. So let's take a look at a more realistic example. Let's take a look at running it twice with a one outer on the river. The formula for calculating the EV for running it twice with a one outer on the river is pretty simple. It's the probability of winning the first hand times the probability of losing the second hand over 2, plus the probability of losing the first hand times the probability of winning the second hand over 2. And that's 1 over 44 times 43 over 43 over 2, plus 43 over 44 times 1 over 43 over 2. And we just reduce that fraction several times until we get 1 over 44. And that's exactly the EV we saw when we were running it 44 times.
The final run.
Ernest's odds continue to get worse and worse, but Phil looks sick anyway.
A queen on the
jack,
turn.
Jack! There's a jack!
You want a jack? That would be sick.
King! King or a jack, one time. There's what, three jacks left? Right now.
The final river card. It's a king!
King!
That's real! He hit three out of four! He hit three out of four!
That's
with the worst hand! Why is everyone so happy except Phil?
And how about running it twice with the two outer on the river? This example is a little bit more complicated because here you have the ability to win both pots. So the formula for calculating the EV of this two outer situation is the probability of winning the first hand times the probability of losing the second hand over 2, plus the probability of losing the first hand times the probability of winning the second hand over 2, plus the probability of winning hand 1 and hand 2. And we just fill in those probabilities and reduce the fractions, and you end up with 2 over 44, which is the EV you would expect if you ran it 44 times. So what about calculating the EV for the more general case of running it n times with z outs? So the formula for calculating the EV of running it n times for a z outer is the sum as I goes from 1 to n of I over n times n choose I times the permutations of z taken I at a time times the permutations of 44 minus z taken n minus I at a time all over the permutations of 44 objects taken n at a time. And in this formula, we are summing up the 1 to n number of pots of the share of the pot that you're going to win, multiplied by the combination of ways you could win that many pots, multiplied by the number of permutations of winning I pots and losing n minus I pots, divided by the number of ways those n cards can be dealt. And we can make several substitutions to this formula until we get here. This formula looks a little strange until you realize we can apply something called Vandermonde's identity. And no, this is not what Voldemort uses to buy beer. This is Vandermonde's identity, which can be used to make the following substitution. And once we've applied Vandermonde's identity, we can reduce the fractions until we get z over 44. So here we have proven that the EV is equal for two players playing heads up on the river, running it n number of times with z number of outs. And we can further extend this formula by substituting y for the 44 unknown cards. So if we knew what the two burn cards were, and we knew what maybe one other player had folded, we could eliminate another 4 cards and use 40 instead of 44. And starting with that same general formula, we can just substitute y for 44, and it will reduce to z over y as your EV. So what have we done here? We've proven that your EV is identical for running it any number of times with any number of outs and any number of unknown cards on the river. Now, we've only proven this for the river, but I assure you that your EV is going to be identical when you run it multiple times on the turn as well. So hopefully you've learned three things. Your EV does not change no matter how many times you run it. Your variance will lower the more times you run it, and your actual result will converge towards your expected result the more times you run it. And if you get lucky, then you might get paid. So that's it. I hope you learned something about running it multiple times. If you did, remember to like and subscribe. And let me know if you like to run it multiple times when you have a big pot. Always gamble responsibly. And peace out, donkeys.
love the chase and the hunt, and I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want, and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm